I was pretty shocked.
Shock?
Yeah, shock. I was really surprised that it happened at our school.
Reaction is coming in following the discovery of a so-called gay list allegedly made by three high school students in Vancouver of their fellow peers. City News has learned the list was shared privately in a Google Doc and contained 100 names of grade 12 students.
This is like the first time in a really long time. Like we're both in grade 11 and yeah. This is the first time like anything like this has happened.
Like everyone gets along for the most part. It's just there's some people who make bad decisions and don't think things through.
It's a very friendly school, at least I found.
The Vancouver School District has confirmed three students have been suspended and in a statement say, staff fully appreciate students may experience a wide range of emotions and reactions to this type of incident. School staff will directly follow up with impacted members of the school community so collectively, students, their families, and staff can move forward in a positive way.
I think it's actually a really, like, accepting school.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Especially compared to some of the other schools.
Yeah.
That's why I was so shocked to see this. It was just really strange.
And I think, like, these articles that are coming out are making Hamba seeing, like, this happens all the time. And that, like, bullying happens in the halls and people are, like, get shoved into lockers, which is totally not what happens.
Meanwhile, students also tell us the intention of the list isn't completely clear, but they believe the homophobic slur that was reportedly used to title it was a blanket term to describe a wider group of people.
I feel like it was more about the people they didn't like in the school, I guess. It was definitely made to cause some, like, harm, obviously.
I think that part of that is true. I don't think that every single one of those people on the list was aimed at being, like, using that word, but I think that there were a lot of people who actually, like, were, you know, so I just...
Behavioral expert Dr. Shimmy K. Kang says there are a couple of factors here she describes as both interesting and relevant.
One is the fact that these are teenagers. And I think that when we look deeper into the teenage brain, we can see patterns that we know are based on their neuroscience, meaning that they are more prone to take risks. They're more prone to act first, think later. They're more prone to do things that may be motivated by impressing their peers. When we see children kind of following the herd mentality, we really wonder about what's happening with their own internal sense of identity. And some research supports that that's being lost with our social media and this idea of having an online identity. That question of who we really are leads us to kind of do things impulsively without thinking and really connected to our own core values.
Is this an incident that's going to bring everyone closer together, or do you think it's going to drive people apart?
I think it's going to bring everybody together besides the people who made the list.
In Vancouver, David Zura, City News.